Welcome to Algebra 2, Lesson 2. Okay, so I've put some of the problems on the board, not all of them. You're expected to go back and fill in whatever I have not done. But we are going to be talking about the order of operation. And in your notebook, right here, these notes will help you out. But I went ahead and drew some of it on the board. Remember that sentence, "Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally." That helps you know the order you're supposed to be doing it in. Please excuse power and exponents. My dear, multiply, divide, Aunt Sally for add and subtract. And the reason it's lined up this way is because you do these according to how they happen, left to right, left to right. So let's look at number 4. So we have a subtraction, and then we have a multiplication, multiplication, division, and multiplication. So multiplication and divisions come before add and subtract, so we will be doing those according to how they come from left to right. So number 1, we have to multiply 6 times 8. Well, 6 times 8 is great because it is 48. That's right. So it's 18 minus 48 times 25 divided by 12 minus 5. Okay, so I just went ahead and wrote the rest down, and now I need to do the next multiplication. Well, when I multiply that, I know it is 1,200. So 18 minus 1,200 divided by 12 minus 5. So division again comes before subtraction, so we'll do that next. So when I divide, that's 18 minus 100, times 5. So 100 times 5 is 500. So 18 minus 500. So we subtract it and take the sign of the larger. Since 500 is larger, our answer is going to be a negative number, and it's going to be a negative 482. Okay? So now we're going to move on to number 6. And again, we don't have any parentheses or exponents, so we're going to look for multiply or divide from left to right. So we have a multiplication. We will do that first. So we have 9 minus 3. Well, 8 times negative 5 is a negative 40. Okay, so now we're going to look for to see if there's any more multiplication or division. And right here is another division. So we'll do that next. And a negative divided by a positive is a negative 20. Alright, now the rest we will put together from left to right. But since they're all the same thing, and that's all that's left, I suggest you put positives together and negatives together. So this is our only positive, so I'm going to put this. And then when we put these together, this is 38, 39, 40, 41. So minus 41. So you take the sign of the larger, 41 is larger, so you have a negative 32 is your answer. Okay, so now we're going to go down to number 10. We have a bunch of these and we have that, because this would be considered parentheses also. But so we see this and we got to look inside to see what we need to do. So inside we have parentheses that we can simplify. So let's start right there. Well, 4 minus 1 is 3. So inside here, that we don't have anything to simplify within the parentheses, but we do have an exponent. So let's go ahead and take care of that exponent. Well, that exponent is the same thing as 2 times 2 times 2. Well, this is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 plus, well, what is 3 times negative 5? Negative 15. Okay? So now we can still simplify. simplify this. And 8 minus 15, round number 10, is negative 7 times by negative 2. I was just making sure I'm right where I'm supposed to be. So a negative times a negative is positive. 7 times 2 is 14. Okay, so that is 14. Again, we started with parentheses. This was inside. We simplified that, did our exponents, put that together, multiplied. Negative times a negative is a positive. Okay, this one up here has these signs, these little symbols right here, and that is absolute value. And the absolute value means the distance from zero. So, how many units is 6 away from zero? So, if we have a number line, we have 0. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units away from 0. So the absolute value of 6 is 6. Now we need to find the absolute value of negative 5. So negative 5 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units away. So the absolute value of 5, negative 5 is 5. And 6 minus 5 is 1. So the answer for 14 is 1. Well, now you need to go on to page 4. And the directions there is to give the answer and its absolute value. So you're going to have two answers on all of them, 6 through 10. All right, so I've put two of them up here, and we'll do those, and you do the rest yourself. So 5 minus 8. Well, this is higher, so it's going to be a negative 3. Well, the absolute value of negative 3 is 3. So there's your answer for number 6. Now let's skip down to number 10. We have a negative and a negative. Since they're the same sign, we're going to go ahead and add them and keep the same sign. So that would be a negative 26. Well, what's the absolute value of negative 26? 26. Good job. All right. So now go back and do the rest. Your assignment is page 6, 2 through 14 all, page 4, 6 through 10. Oh, I'm sorry, page 6 was 2 through 14 even, but the 6 through 10 is all. All right, bye.